Ang tanong ng iba yan, it's 2024 days, almost 7 years. Mm-hmm. Hindi ka pa ba pagod? Other people would ride off, frankly, into the sunset, have a quiet life. You know what I mean? They'll say, okay, I'm staying off politics. I'm gonna change careers. I'm gonna plant vegetables or something, right? But not you. I mean, the minute you got out, you said it's a time of reckoning. You're not coming out with bitterness. You have forgiveness, but it's a time of reckoning and accountability. Other people won't go that route.
Mm-hmm. After all what was done to me, why should I quit? I didn't quit in the entire almost 7 years of detention. And why should I quit now? Then I would have the opportunity now, and I would have the time to attain my, to achieve full vindication. And why would I quit now that I see the right environment to pursue what I've been pursuing? You know, the developments that we are seeing, that, you know, there's a possibility that the government, the current government, would reverse its original position on the ICC. Mm-hmm. That who knows, the final position would be to rejoin the ICC, that the position would be to, because if we rejoin, then automatically we need to cooperate. Okay. Or even if we do not rejoin ICC, we still have the duty to cooperate, notwithstanding our withdrawal.
Okay. If President Marcos Jr. is watching now and he would see this, what benefit is it to him, frankly, and his administration to rejoin the ICC? You'd have advisors of the president saying, the U.S. isn't even a part of the ICC, Mr. President. Why would you go to the ICC? It'll divide you politically. So I'm acting, right? If I were advising the president, why would you? Why should he?
It is the right thing to do for justice and accountability. It is the right thing to do in order to earn more positive points from the international community, not necessarily the U.S., but the likes of the European Union. You know, because joining the Rome Statute would give us the opportunity now to also join the community of nations that would fight impunity, that would fight tyrants, you know, in states where there would be aberrations of their domestic justice system. There would be aberrations of their political systems, that tyrants would rise, one man rule would be there. And then that's exactly what happened in 2016 to 2022, the aberrations that was the Duterte despotic rule, which result in the carnage, the almost daily carnage, that no one has thought of putting him to accountability. So it is the right thing to do. And not to rejoin would be wholly inconsistent with our track record in affirming human rights principles. We are parties to key international human rights instruments, human rights treaties. And we've been among those who have been active in the formative stage of the Rome Statute and ICC. So why not rejoin the community of nations who would combat tyrants and who would combat impunity?
Okay. Senator Bato de la Rosa has said you need Senate concurrence. Well, right now that would be 18 votes to go back into the ICC. Would you agree?
I agree with the position of former Senate President Drilon that an executive action would suffice. Because in the first place, the withdrawal was unilateral. The withdrawal, yes, was completed according to the Supreme Court in the Pangilinan et al. Versus Cayetano et al. But there was never any ruling as to the validity and constitutionality of that withdrawal. It would have been different
really
if the Supreme Court categorically ruled that the withdrawal was proper, that it was consistent with the Constitution, that there was nothing wrong with the withdrawal. Because the petition was mooted. Mm. It was moot because at the time that the petitions were filed, according to that decision, the withdrawal was completed already. It was complete. So the Supreme Court did not any more categorically rule on the validity or the constitutionality of the withdrawal, but it did lay down very exhaustively very significant principles on the matter of withdrawal. Mm.
So clearly you feel right now it's just an executive decision.
Yes.
That's it.
Yes.
No need for the long process of rejoining again.
Yes.
That's simple.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the president being the chief architect of foreign policy. And so I would hope that his legal advisors would thoroughly study the matter, the Rome Statute itself, the various relevant provisions there, and also the Pangilinan et al. Versus Cayetano et al. Ruling. Because the withdrawal, in fact, yes, the president has some leeway in withdrawing, but there must be definite showing of repugnance to the Constitution, that the adherence to the Rome Statute was violative of the Constitution. Mm. It should have been shown. It should have been manifested in the very act of withdrawal.
Okay, so we don't have enough time to close. I mean, you've already said that you're not running for the Senate.
Yes.
In 2025, am I correct?
I'm not yet thinking about it.
Yeah, so 2025, let's put it there, that's off the table.
Yes.
No, that's gone. So what are your plans? I mean, I want to go short term. Christmas is coming up. This will be your first Christmas at home with your mother, your family, after 7 years.
Yes, it's going to be the best Christmas ever. Well, my immediate plan is to set the process of my going back to private law practice. That's okay. Why next week I'll be starting with my MCLE.
Okay.
Because
I'm not a lawyer. Can you explain that,
please? The mandatory continuing legal education. You have to gain certain units.
So you'll study again?
Yes, some units.
Oh.
Because, well, I used to be exempt when I was DOJ secretary and as a senator, but now no longer. So I enrolled at the UP for the MCLE program.
I
was told that I had to obtain a total of 36 units. So that would be several law subjects.
Two SEMs?
Not really one SEM, but it's a staggered duration of various law subjects.
It's amazing.
Before I can really formally practice.
Yeah.
And then I'm thinking of resuming also my teaching. I had an offer from the DLSU Law, College of Law, and I accepted it. Mm. I'm going to teach starting on January 22 at the College of Law of DLSU.
Okay. What about talks abroad? I mean, I can imagine these, I mean, human rights forums, really. Mm-hmm. Governance, politics. You have Maria Ressa heading the Global Policy Institute in Colombia, I think next year.
Mm-hmm. I've received several invitations already for official for foreign engagements, but I'd rather that I first focus on the last remaining case. That I'd rather that my remaining case would be over before I accept those invitations.
All right,
various engagements
so
abroad.
Last words, Laila De Lima today.
Well, I remain to be the same Laila De Lima that you used to know. Unbroken, fearless, and I continue to be so.
On that note, I want to thank you so much, former Senator Laila De Lima, for being here on Head Start Live. You've seen the changes. You were once here, I mean, before and now. You've just seen just how life has changed. It completely.